Hello.
Hi, baby.
Hi, honey. Good morning.
How are you?
I'm well. I'm getting ready for the day.
Oh, yeah, me too. How are the roads where you are?
Oh, a little sloppy, but, you know, I left early. I left some extra time so I could be safe, and as always, I'm traveling hands-free today.
Oh, yes. I as well. So what's going on in your day today?
Well, you know, this teaching world, got to gear it up for those eighth graders.
Yeah, the eighth graders.
Can always be a challenge, but I'm most excited about the concert choir today because we're getting ready for contest next week. So
Okay. They've
been really working on their Latin.
Okay, sounds good. Is that something I can pray for you about today?
You know, yes, and more so even for energy and stamina, so I can cheerlead all day long and get all those singers excited through the day.
Great.
How about you? What's on your agenda today?
Oh, I've got a really big meeting today with the executive committee, so just want to make sure that that report I worked on last night really goes well.
Okay.
So.
Well, you're up late, so I'll make sure that you're also refreshed and full of energy today.
Thank you. That'd be great.
Hope it goes very smoothly, and I'll pray for that for you.
Awesome. Thanks. Well, are you ready to pray?
I am.
Excellent.
Okay.
You or me?
It's your turn.
Of course.
Okay.
All right. Here we go. Awesome and amazing God, thank you so much for this blessed day, the wonderful gift of life that you give us each and every day, and for the beauty of this relationship. We know that you are present in this relationship and in our family. We thank you so much for those blessings. Lord, we ask that you be with us today as you bless Nicki and the eighth graders and getting her choir ready for contest. We just know that you're going to give her a lot of peace and love and energy and understanding. And for myself, I just want to make that meeting go smoothly that I'm hoping that the report turns out well for, and just want to make sure that everything goes well for my harmony and my peace today. Lord, we ask that you be with our friends and family near and far, all those in need of your healing hand and your grace, your suffering, or your grace in their suffering and your forgiveness. And Lord, we ask all this in your son's holy name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, honey. That was beautiful.
Oh, you're welcome, baby. Well, have a great day. I love you so much. And I hope that you have an awesome day.
Yeah, I can't wait to see you tonight. Have a good day, too.
Thanks. Bye-bye.
Okay, bye-bye. So, Travis and I have been married for 8 years, and we do not have children, but like all of you, we have very demanding jobs, and oftentimes we have responsibilities that go well into our evenings and well into weekends. And so we don't often get the have the privilege of sitting down every night at a certain time for meals. And sometimes we don't see each other till well after dark. And so a lot of our communication and prayer time and spiritual time together happens on the road, of course, hands-free, like I said before. Always safe and paying attention to each other and paying attention to the road. But it's the only time we really have that's kind of our own and that we can really communicate together. So we found that to be very valuable. It also, having so much time apart, makes the evenings that we are together extra special.
Hi, honey.
Hi, honey. Good evening.
Good to see you.
How was your day?
It was excellent. How was yours?
It was good. Yeah, the eighth graders ripped me up a little bit, but I survived.
Oh, those eighth graders.
Yeah.
You gotta love them. Yeah. Some eighth graders over there.
Yeah. How'd your meeting go?
It went very well. It went very well.
Good.
But first and foremost, Nicki Tolliver, child of God, I love and adore you. And I'm so thankful to be back home with you safely.
Travis Tolliver, child of God, I love and adore you. And I'm so glad that we are both together safely.
All right. Well, hey, should we look at our scripture reading for today?
Yeah, let's make sure we focus on that before we go to the gym today.
Oh, yeah, that's right. It's that night, too. All right, so our scripture reading tonight comes from Deuteronomy, verses 10 through 22. And if we were at church, I would definitely say you could find this in your pew Bibles on page 147.
Okay. That's a good
reminder. But we're not, so we're going to go on. The essence of the law. So now, O Israel, what does the Lord your God require of you? Only to fear the Lord your God, to walk in all his ways, to love him, to serve the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul, and to keep the commandments of the Lord your God and his decrees that I am commanding you today for your own well-being. Although heaven and the heaven of heavens belongs to the Lord your God, the earth with all that is in it, yet the Lord set his heart in love on your ancestors alone and chose you, their descendants, after them, out of all the peoples, as it is today. Circumcise, then, the foreskin of your heart, and do not be stubborn any longer. For the Lord your God is God of gods and Lord of lords, and the great God, mighty and awesome, who is not partial and takes no bribe, who executes justice for the orphan and the widow, and who loves the strangers, providing them with food and clothing. You shall also love the stranger, for you were strangers in the land of Egypt. You shall fear the Lord your God, him alone. You shall worship to him, you shall hold fast, and by his name you shall swear. He is your praise, he is your God, who has done for you these great and awesome things that your own eyes have seen. Your ancestors went down to Egypt 70 persons, and now the Lord your God has made you as numerous as the stars in heaven.
Very powerful.
So what do we get from that? What are you getting from?
Well, I think it's really interesting that he uses the word circumcise.
Yeah, me too.
Because we
we often associate that with a different time
in our lives, or in, you know.
I love that it gives
the image of peeling away that hard, calloused layer in our hearts. And
I know I work with some people that have those calloused hearts, and to peel
away that and look at the refreshed, alive, beating heart.
That's a beautiful vision.
I really enjoy too how the verse talks a lot about the Lord our God and making sure that he is the center of everything that we do, eat, breathe, say. It's just a great reminder that he comes first in all things, and it's just fascinating.
Ding dong. Hey guys, I thought I would just come and visit you and deliver a new microphone for you.
Thank you. That is so nice of you. Would you like a cup of coffee? Oh, never mind. Have a good night. I love when we get company.
Yeah, the kindness of neighbors. Yeah,
yes.
That's great.
Sugar, microphones, really, you know.
Yeah, you should have thought twice after moving next to the pastor. But anyway, anything else that you get from that?
Well, there's a lot of other things, too. I love the line about the ancestors and how important that legacy is. But I think we should talk about how we can apply it to our lives. I mean, how does it become real for us?
Well, I guess just looking at the passage, it just reminds me that I need to put God first in everything that I do and say. And just, you know, often think of him as being in the passenger seat when we are going to work every morning and we pray.
I think that's a good reminder.
So let's end our night in prayer.
All right.
Okay.
You or me?
It's your turn.
Heavenly Father, Lord, thank you for this amazing day of energy and peace and grace. And your blessings just continue to overflow. And we are so grateful for each and every one of them, big and small. And for the protection of our travels this morning and bringing us safely together tonight. And we look forward to seeing our family in Christ on Sunday as we continue to study your word through the week and how powerful it becomes for us. In your holy name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
All right, let's go to the gym.
Okay. Dinner. And that's how we do that.
And Nicki Travis, thank you, not only for making that look very doable, but also so fun. So the only thing else I have to say is, you have seen, now go and do. Let's join in our hymn.